Webhooks play a very important role on Bitrise. Continuous integration works best when everything is automated, and we don't want to waste your time by forcing you to manually start your Bitrise builds. Webhooks can work two ways. Incoming webhooks automatically trigger builds on Bitrise whenever there is a code change in your repository, for example a code push or a pull request. Remember, these are used to tell Bitrise that something changed in your code. There are two very simple ways to set one up. Both require that your Git provider account, for example, your GitHub account, is connected to your Bitrise account. If your Git provider account is not connected, skip forward a bit. The easiest way to register a webhook when you add the new app to Bitrise. When you get to the end of the process, you are prompted to register a webhook. Just click here, and you are done. Bitrise automatically adds the webhook to the app's repository. If you didn't do this when adding the app, or if you just want to add another webhook, don't worry, it's simple. Go to your app and find its code tab. Scroll down to the incoming webhook section and click Setup Automatically. Again, Bitrise automatically adds the webhook to the app's repository. If your Git provider account is not connected, or if you want to set up an incoming webhook at some other service, such as Slack, then you need to manually set up a webhook. This isn't much more complicated than the previous method. Go to the code tab again, find the incoming webhook section again, but this time click Setup Manually. Now, choose the service from the drop-down menu, and then from here, copy the webhook URL for the selected service. This is the URL you need to add your service of choice. And that's it! From now on, your selected service can notify Bitrise about code events, and you can use this to trigger builds automatically. Check out our video on the subject. Now let's talk about outgoing webhooks a bit. Outgoing webhooks notify other services about Bitrise build events, when a build is triggered, and when it's finished. They aren't any more complicated to set up than incoming webhooks. Go to your app's code tab again, and scroll down to the outgoing webhook section. Click the Add Webhook button. Then decide which events should trigger the webhook. For now, select the Send Me Everything option. Add the webhook URL of the service, and then, optionally, you can define custom headers. Just set a key and a value, click Add Header, and that's it. When you are done with all that, click Create Webhook. Now you know the most important things about webhooks on Bitrise. Read more about them in our documentation, and of course go on and try them out.